हेलो मेकर्स, वेलकम टू मेकरशाला। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग फाइन एंड वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इनटू दिस थर्ड लेसन ऑफ और द थर्ड एपिसोड ऑफ द लॉकडाउन सीरीज। सो हियर वी आर डूइंग लाइव स्ट्रीम्स ऑन एवरी संडे एंड एवरी वेंसडे एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिल्ड अ वेब पोर्टफोलियो एंड वी विल लर्न बेसिक्स ऑफ वेब डिजाइनिंग यूजिंग CSS एंड HTML। ओके, सो आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन एंड सो दिस इज अ प्रोजेक्ट यू आर एबल टू सी ऑन टू द स्क्रीन। दिस इज वी आर गोइंग टू बिल्ड फर्दर इन टू द सेशन and first of all we'll just wait for a couple of minutes and we'll just explore the makershala.com till more people will join, okay, so that all of us can join from the beginning, because what happens when we start and so first 10 minutes are really important. So if some people are joining late and we start here, so they just miss what we are going to do, so it's a little bit of not a good experience for all of them. So we'll just do some bit of chit chat here. So all of you, I'm able to recognize some of the people here. And okay, hello Zaina. Okay, so I hope the video and audio is perfectly clear for everyone. And okay, good morning all. I hope all of you are doing good. Okay, so here, before we start, so here this is, I am at makershala.com. So right now we are having a contest to design a face mask. So this is a face mask challenge. You can click here and participate into this contest. So you have to design a face mask using material from the home, the clothes and other things. And we have some exciting prizes also. So first runner up. So we have some prizes here. The grand prize is a tinker.com subscription. Tinker.com is a online learning platform where you can learn a lot of things. And then we have first prize as of a cardboard construction kit. And then we have runner-up prize of as a Makershala t-shirts. Okay. So we organize a lot of competitions on makershala.com, contests and competitions. So you can participate in them and win exciting prizes. So now I'll just quickly explore the community tab here. So this is the community tab where you can publish your projects. So in last couple of sessions, in first session we have covered about Scratch, and then we covered about how to design thinking using Tinkercad. So a lot of students are posting really good projects. So these all projects are made by students. So this is a project made by Sarvjot Singh, designing a coffee mug using Tinkercad. So you can also just record a video or take screenshots and explain what you have done in your project. So here you can see all of the screenshots, the process to make a coffee mug. And so it was a group tutorial so that all of other people can also learn what you are building. And then I also have a project here. So a student made a game. So this was a flying wizard game, which is made by Komal Jain. And then we also had a game, the similar game, which I taught to make in the session. So it is good that you document your journey for learning things. It is better so that other people can also learn from you, how you made that from your process, and you can share your work with others and get famous. So here, a lot of people are here, so I guess we can start now. So if you haven't subscribed to YouTube channel yet, please hit the subscribe button and like this video, because we are streaming two videos in a week. One comes on the Sunday at 11 a.m. which is today at this time, and then we have a stream on Wednesdays, which is in the evening at 6 o'clock. Okay, so I hope all of you are subscribe to Makershala, because then only you will get the notification, and press the bell icon also. Okay, so I guess we can start now. So first of all, what we are going to do today, so right now do not start any coding or stuff. So I'll just give you the introduction. So this is my web portfolio. So what is the web portfolio? So we all do a lot of things. We have different skills, we have education, we have built a lot of projects, and we have won some awards also. But I want to show all of these, my capabilities, the things I have done, the things I am doing to the world. So for that, what we can have a resume also, which you can write. So resume is a 20th century thing. Now we are in 21st century. We are in the world of websites, internet, social media. So why not to make a web portfolio so that you can showcase your work online to the people. So here, this is my web portfolio. So I have added, this is the front page of the portfolio. So here it is, my picture, my name, a thing about me, and then my tagline, you can add yours. And then these are my skills. So programming, designing, multimedia, and personal skills. So all of these skills. And then we have the projects. These projects are made by me. So these are dummy projects. The text is not actual here. This is just to showcase. So like that, you can add projects and you can just give the link to the projects if you have made some videos or other things. And then we have awards. So if you have won some awards or participated in a competition where you get some recognition or you publish some papers, so you can add these onto your web page. And then I have a contact me section where through which you can contact me. So you can see all of these social media icons. So the Facebook, so this is not just an image. If you click onto this button, it will take you to the twitter.com, or if you add your profile here, so it will directly take the users to the your profile. So this is pretty cool. You can add your address here, your phone number, your email ID, your Makershala account, the Instagram account, so all of these things. So we are going to learn how to build this, and we are eventually going to build this thing in this session. So I hope all of you are excited. How many of you are excited? Comment down below. Are you excited to build this thing? Are you excited? Hello audience, are you excited? Because I am pretty excited. So I hope we should get started. So this is the project what we are going to build. And now I would like to share some of the things before we get started, because what is the importance of building a web portfolio? So you made some projects, and so right now, if you are not a educator, you are not a professional, you are still in school, in 8th standard, 10th standard, or even 6th standard if you are very young, welcome here, you are at the right time, at the right place. So then why do you need a web portfolio? Because what happens in India, we have exams like IIT or other entrance exams to get into the elite educational institutions. But if you want to study outside, like Oxford University, Harvard, MIT, so what they do not conduct assessment tests like we do here. So they prefer to take interviews and to showcase your projects. So if you go there, if you tell them that, okay, these are the projects which is made by me, so it has a higher chance that you may get selected into the college of your choice. So if you are a student, you can apply for scholarship, you can apply for internship, you can apply for an education. So that is why a web portfolio is must for everyone. And then we have other things. For example, you are a graphic designer, so you cannot showcase all of your work, your graphics, with just the resume. You need a certain web presence. If you are a web developer, if you are a web designer, you need a web presence so that you can showcase your work. So for example, graphic designers, photographers, videographers, all of them. So if you make yourself present onto the internet through your personal web page, so that more of the customers or the contacts come to you and they can work with you, or you can work with them. So that is why having a web portfolio is a must for everyone. Okay, so now we have understood all of the importance of a web portfolio, why it is required. Now we'll just quickly see that what is a website. Okay, so before the website, we can see if you type, go to any website, you need www dot certain domain name. So we have a couple of things. So first of all, what is www? So www is World Wide Web, and it is the internet if we talk on to the larger perspective. So it is the internet where you can do things like watch movies and stuff, and do some productive work also, like we are doing here. So then we have our domain name. So domain name is your address. For example, if you are living at some place, then you have an address, for example, house number 10, sector this and that. Okay, so that is your address. And in similar way, a website has an address, so that is called as domain name. So for example, we have www.makershala.com, so that is our domain name, our web address. And then we have youtube.com, all of these. So these are called the domains or the web address. And then we have the hosting. So hosting is actually the house where website is located. So for example, if we talk about hosting in the real life, so your house is your hosting, where you are living and doing all of the things, studying, eating, sleeping and other stuff. Okay, so hosting, what is the meaning of hosting? Hosting is nothing but just a computer. So a website needs a lot of things to work. So a website need the, first of all, a computer to work. And then in computer, we have RAM, the memory, the graphics card, the storage. So all of these things are provided by a hosting service. For example, we have GoDaddy, Heroku, and others. Like Google is also providing hostings. AWS from the Amazon Web Services, they are also providing a hosting. So hosting is nothing but a computer, someone else's computer, where you run your website from. Okay, so that it can serve a larger audience. So that is how, that is the difference between a domain name and the hosting. So this is just the basic stuff. And then we come on to the a website. So how does a website work? Can anyone tell me in the comments how a website works, or what are the components of a website? So now we are we will move a little bit slower, because in the last time a lot of people are complaining that I am moving a little bit faster. Okay, so if you want me to move a little bit faster or slower, you can comment down below. We can adjust the pace accordingly. Okay. Okay. So a website has certain components. So first was a domain name, which is the address, and then the hosting, which is actually the place where website lives. And then we have, you must have heard these buzzwords like backend and front end. So what are these? So a backend is where we define the actual functionality of a website. So in case of a YouTube, the backend is how the videos are stored, where the videos are stored, which video to play, and once you search something onto the search bar and you type the search button, so it searches through the all of the data it has. So that is how the backend is working. So backend is created using languages such as Python. You must have heard it, a very famous language. C++, Java, JavaScript also, Ruby, okay, and Go, very famous nowadays. Okay, so these are the languages which are used to program the backend. Backend defines the whole functionality of the website, where the data is stored, how data is retrieved, which are the images. So all of the functionality is stored or governed using the backend. So then we have the front end. So front end is what you see. Right now you are on YouTube, so you are seeing a video is being played, you have a like button, you have a subscribe button, hit the subscribe button, and then you have the comments, you can comment down below. So these are called as front end, what you see, what any user see onto the screen, the colors, the text, all of these things. Okay, so these are made using HTML and then CSS. I'll define all of these things, and then we have JavaScript. Okay, so first we have the backend, and then we have the front end. So backend governs how the website will work, the functionality, and front end will define how a website looks. Okay, a little bit of animations, all of these things are governed using the front end. And then you can also like differentiate between the terms as web development and web designing. So development means how website is actually working, or the backend stuff, and then web design, how website is looking. So that is comes under category of front end. So I hope all of these terms are clear to everyone. So now you may be wondering that why JavaScript is in the both of the things, JavaScript in the backend also and in the front end also, because JavaScript is a very dope language. It is very good language. You can do a lot of things with it. It is currently my favorite also. So we'll see if we can we will see if we can explain that stuff also. So I hope everybody is clear till now. Okay, so we are I think we are clear by now what is web development, designing, backend, front end, etc. So now in this lecture, in this session, we are going to discuss only about the front end. Okay, so I'll just remove the back end stuff from here. So we will discuss only the front end. What is front end, how to build it, and what is HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Okay, so what is front end? Front end, like I told you that front end, it defines how the website is looking, the colors, the shape of the button, all of the shapes, the animation. So all of these things come under the front end. And then we have the HTML, CSS and the JavaScript to make it happen. So how many of you know HTML or what HTML is doing on a website? Can you tell me in the comments how many of you know about the HTML? Anyone? Okay. So someone is asking that why JavaScript comes under both categories. Okay. So I think I need to come on to this topic. Okay. So JavaScript actually, when it started, it was running in the browser. So JavaScript runs inside the browser. So you have browser like Chrome, Firefox, Safari. So here JavaScript runs inside the browsers, and it is mainly was used at first for the animations and the interactivity stuff. Like you click here and button shows you something, something pops up. So all of these things are created using JavaScript. So a JavaScript is, for example, if every programming language, we need a compiler to work. For example, if you have C++, you need a compiler for C++ so that the machine can understand your language. In the same way, we have a JavaScript engine so that it can understand the JavaScript. So that engine was, or also right now also, is inbuilt inside a web page, or sorry, the browser. So JavaScript engine is built inside the browser. So you type some JavaScript, or some JavaScript was already in the website, so it runs in the browser. So there were some smart people, they thought, why can't I just take this engine out from the browser and then I use the JavaScript to make the backend so that I can store the data, I can communicate with different websites or different web page. So some couple of smart people, they build a framework called as node.js, or simply called as node.js. So that is used to build the backend also. So okay, so I wrote the JavaScript in the backend. So the actual thing for that is Node.js, but we program using JavaScript. So with that way, you can code your front end also and backend using JavaScript, but you still need HTML and CSS. So now I'll come on to the HTML. So HTML is called as a hypertext markup language. So HTML defines the bare bone, the structure of the website. So what is the structure? Structure is how the text is coming, where the text is coming, and the buttons, the paragraphs, the images, all of these things are defined using an HTML. So HTML and CSS both are not a programming language. Let me clarify, HTML and CSS are not the programming languages, they are styling languages so that we can build a web page. So HTML is used to build the structure of a web page. So if we compare it to the human body, you can say that the bone structure, okay, the skeleton is the HTML. Without HTML, there could not be any website. And then we have the CSS. So CSS is used to style the web page, like the colors of the button, the shapes of button, images, borders, boundaries, padding, all of these things are defined using CSS. So without the CSS, the websites will look very ugly, like they used to look in 90s or early 2000. Okay. And then, so the CSS, if we compare it to the human body, you can say it when we are putting clothes onto a person and we are styling the hairs, we are putting gels and other stuff, jewelries. So this is comes under the styling. So the JavaScript is a hypertext markup language, and then the CSS is a styling language. and then comes the JavaScript. JavaScript is actually a programming language, and we add the front end functionality using the JavaScript. We make our website interactive so that it can interact with the users. You can press some buttons and it can do some things. You can add animations. So all of these things. So in this section, in this session, we are only going to discuss HTML and CSS. So I'll rub off the JavaScript also. So HTML and CSS are both very, very, very important component of any website. Without them, there could be nothing. You build a backend, but what backend will do if there is a no web page? Okay, the web page built using HTML and CSS. Okay, so and then I can show you a website, a very good website. So I'll just type the link here. I think it takes me to the right place. Okay, so this is a website. It is actually an interactive resume, or I should say a portfolio. So if you just click here, you can see this person has made this interactive portfolio in form of a game. Okay, so this is a I think it looks like the Mario one, if you have ever played the game. So you can say that it is level 1, and I am pressing the space button, and now you can see multidisciplinary designs, and you can also move using the scroll also. So you can see, and these are the design, the person's skills and the levels of the skills. So the design is having expert level skills, in illustration also advanced skills, and then code is intermediate skills, in animation also intermediate skills. So you can list your skills here, and then we have where the person is living, locations, and then what are the interests, like in case here the sports, the NBA fan, the level 2 is skills. So now we are going into more of the details of the skills, and then we have graphic and web software skills, the Photoshop has this much, and then we have scripting and programming language skills, so all of these languages and other software skills. So I think it is a really, really good way to showcase your skills rather than just a piece of paper called resume. So if you are an educator, if you are a student, it is a must for everyone to have the web presence. Okay, you can just share your link with anyone and showcase your work. So these are the working experience, and then another working experience, one more. So these are awards and publications. Okay, so you can see all of these things here. So this website was made using HTML, CSS, and the JavaScript. So all of the animation, the person is moving, how I am moving the mouse button, all of these things are made possible by JavaScript. Okay, but in this session, we are not going to use JavaScript. We will just focus on HTML and CSS. Okay, and how we are going to do that, on which platform? So we are going to use something called as Glitch. So Glitch.com is the Glitch.com. So Glitch.com is a website where you can program web pages and websites. So what happens when you are building a website or when you are building a web app? So there are a lot of things. You set up the environment, you make your computer ready, you install some libraries and softwares, all those things. So for a beginner, it is very daunting task. So if you are just starting with the web development, it becomes very tedious to set up all of these things and keep track of files. So what the Glitch is doing, Glitch is making all of these things easy. So Glitch is saying, you don't worry about the environment, I have set up everything for you, you just start building things and you can deploy things also. So whenever we are building things, first of all, we do not directly deploy that thing to the website. Okay, we directly do not go for the hosting. First we build that in the computer, and then we purchase a domain name and host our web page there. Okay, so what is Glitch doing here? You can just make a web page and then you can host that here from here only. You can just share a link and you do not need to pay anything for the hosting also, nothing for the domain name. You can just make your portfolio here and you can host from here also. Okay, you can just share the link with the people and those people will be able to access or see your profile. Okay, so the link name is glitch.com. Okay, so you can just go on to the glitch.com. And here I'll quickly sign out from here and then I'll sign in again. So once you open it, it is going to look something like this. So it is a free platform. So it is a free platform where you can build things. So you can click here onto the glitch.com, join Glitch. And if you can join using multiple accounts, Facebook, the GitHub, the Google. So it is best for me that I have the Google account here. So click onto the Google and choose the account which you want to use. And welcome to the Glitch. Okay, so now I hope everybody is logged in to the Glitch, everybody here, so that we can move forward now. Everyone here, everyone. And if you like this video, if you are loving the content which I am delivering to you, make sure you hit the like button. Okay, it is really important. So you just keep giving me feedback so that I can improve on some things and we can make this really interesting. Okay, so I hope everybody is with me. Yes, for those the people, those who are using watching this stream in mobile, it is important that you have a laptop so that you can work, because we are going to do some coding here. Okay, so you can do that in laptop. You can do that in phone also, but it is not the ideal device for that. So now we will just click onto this new project button. So if you click here onto the new project, so here a couple of things open. So so here is these are some things. First of all, first is hello web page. This is just going to be a simple plain web page which we are going to build, nothing backend, nothing stuff. No database and others. Then you can also create backend, the Node.js app, which will also include the backend, and then you can add the database also on Glitch only. So we are just going to use the hello web page option because we are just building a static web page. Okay, no JavaScript, no functionality. But just a static web page so that you can just showcase your information. So just click onto the hello web page button. Yes, Deepak Gupta, you can use JavaScript in the Glitch, and here we are just going to use HTML and CSS for now. Okay, so it is loading. So here you can see a couple of things. So at first this may look very overwhelming, a lot of information is being thrown at you from multiple sources, from video and from the computer screen. So here you can see a couple of things here. First of all, onto the left section, you can see here some files. So we have the readme.md. It is going to be a text file. So you are building something, you can document your journey. You can write that, okay, for this, I need these libraries. And if you want to make this application or this web app work, you can add all of these things. Okay, so we are not hosting, I will not say that we are hosting it on a server, we are hosting it onto the Glitch server. So Glitch is providing all of these things. I just wait for a while, I'll clear all of these things. When you leave this stream, when this stream will end, you will have no doubt, I'll make sure that, okay. And yes, we are going to learn CSS, we will learn HTML, and we are going to learn CSS also. Okay, so this is, I think this looks pretty cool. All of the colors and the shapes, and we are going to learn all of these things. Yes, there are some things which I would like to tell about changing the name or the domains about your website. We will come on to that. So first of all, if you are here, if you just click here and onto this button, this is your project option. You click here and you can see that this is the name of your project. You can obviously change it, but make sure that this is a unique one, because Glitch is a public platform. You can build your project and you can share with other people also if you are not making it private. So if your project is not private, a lot of people can see it and they can also copy it, okay, obviously with your permission. And so I'll just change the name here. So I'll make it as Vishal Sharma, which is my name, 123. Okay, so you can because I have made a couple of my portfolios here when I was testing, so you can choose any name what you want. I hope it is available. And then you can make this project private also, that other people cannot see what is inside your project or the code of your project. Okay, so I'll click here. You can leave it open the public also, that is of no issue. And if you are, I think you are, you all of you are maybe able to see this as a white. Okay, so my theme is black. So if I click onto this change theme button, it becomes white. And if you click here again, so it chooses as the night theme. Okay, so JavaScript is an another programming language. Kushav Jindal, we can discuss a couple of things when all of these things are over, and we may plan a JavaScript session in the future. Okay, no worries about that. And then, so I hope all of you are here till now. And then we have a lot of files here. First of all, we have assets. So in assets, you can upload your files. For example, you need images and you need other documents to upload onto a website. So you can upload all of the things here. How that will do above, I'll tell you. And then we have this index.html. Okay. And before that, how you will see what your code is doing. So you click here and you can see next to the code button, and here you will see your output. So this is the output of this code. So this is written in HTML, and here we have the CSS for the styling. So you can see that this is the output of your HTML and CSS, your basic web page. Okay. So you can just see the output here only. And if you want to see that in a different tab, in a different window, you can just click onto the show and in a new window. So now it will open up a new tab and you can see your project here. Okay, so I'll use both. Okay, on and off, I'll use both. So what I'll do, here you can see here that this web page is having inbuilt three files. So one is HTML and another is script.js and another is style.css. okay, so we do not need the script.js file here. So I'll just click here and I'll delete it. Okay, it is up to you if you want to delete. It is your choice. Otherwise, we are not going to do anything in the JavaScript here. Okay, and then we have the index.html. Okay, so I'll just erase everything from here. And because we are going to start in the start from the beginning, I hope all of you are able to see me, see the code properly. So I'll just zoom it a little bit. Okay, and in the styling also, I'll delete everything. Okay, so I hope everybody is ready. Everybody has made an account onto the Glitch and they have had a basic tour of the environment. What are the things, what are the features available onto the Glitch? Okay, so that now we can start the coding. So now we will start the coding. Okay, so I hope I can start with the HTML now. Okay, so just go onto the glitch.com, make an account and start a new project. So now we will start with an HTML. So HTML, as I told you, it is defining the structure of a web page. So if I'll just write anything here, I'll just write here H1. I will tell you what all of these things are. So if I'll tell you H1 and I'll type hello world, although it is not a coding language, but still I'm using this example. Okay. So now you can see I have written a text here and it is showing onto the web page. Okay. So I the video may have paused here. Okay, so but I am here only. I hope all of you are able to listen to me. Okay, no worries. Video, we are working on the video. So the program, you do not need to do anything to run the program. Okay, it is running automatically. Once you do stuff, you write something here and it is running automatically. So you do not need to press any button to run this program. Although if you are here onto a different web page, you can just refresh it and it will show you the output here. Okay, and so all of you who are done with the sign up, you can just explore the environment first and then you can start building things. Okay, so I hope now I am visible to everyone. Okay, so I'll make myself in this side. Actually, these are the things when we are working with the technology, so a little of these glitches are keep coming. So if you are a true learner or you are a true maker, you can understand that whenever we are building something, there are some obstacles which are keep coming onto, so we do not worry about the obstacle, we just keep doing the things which we are doing. So here you can see the basic HTML. So you write something and all of these things are displayed onto the screen. Okay, so now I am onto the right side. If it interface with us, if it interface in the web page, I'll change myself to the different side. Okay, so now what is an HTML? So HTML is having a lot of tags which we are used to do or build things. So first of all, whenever we are writing an HTML, we start with this less than, and the first thing is the HTML keyword. Okay, and we write this, the open less than bracket, and we write the HTML, and then we close it. And then if you want to close this whole thing, we do the less than, and we write the slash and the HTML keyword, and then again the closing symbol. Okay, so that is how we open a file and then we close the file. Okay, so there is one more thing which we write when we start the HTML. I'll tell you that later why we do, because the learning the basic is really important first. So this is how we start any HTML web page. Whatever you write on a web page, it comes here only in the HTML section. Okay, so the first thing in the HTML is head. So the beauty of using glitch is here that it auto completes your text, whatever you're writing here, and it is also having this format, this file feature. You can just click here and it will reformat your code and it will make it look beautiful, because we use a lot of spaces, unnecessary spaces, although it does not interfere with our project, but it is good to make your code readable, so that if you share it with anyone, and the person may not be angry with you. Okay, so first we need the head. Inside the head, we define a couple of things. First thing is the title. So the title is the title of your web page, what you see onto the screen. So here I will write my portfolio. Okay, so here you can see onto the right side, I have this web page open here. So now you can see this is the current app, the web page I am building. This is the app here in the live section. Here you can see the title has changed. It is my portfolio. Okay, so that is how we write the title. And inside the head, we write other things also. Like if you want to specify some basic stuff. If you want to add link to the CSS and the JavaScript, we define in the head section only. And then after the head, we have the body. Okay, so inside the body, whole of the things comes under. Okay, everything you write, if you have writing any text or making buttons or the images, all of these things come under the body section. Okay, and body can also have multiple tags. Actually, there is one thing that there is a saying, everyone's HTML and CSS is different, because you can do these kind of things in a different ways. I may be using a one way and you may be using a different way, depending upon different projects, depending upon different web page, depending upon the ability of a person. We use different things, we have different skill levels. Okay, if you see a professional, the person who is building a web page or a website, he may be using this stuff differently, and we are just starting right now here, we are just getting the introduction, so we are using the stuff differently. Okay, so no need to worry about all of these things. The goal here is to learn the basics, and meanwhile learning, you can build something. Okay, so we are building, we are learning using building. So in the body, we have different tags. So first is the h1. So h1 is for the heading. So you can see here, I'll write something. So heading 1, and then I'll add h2 also. The whole principle is same. You write the less than bracket and you write the tag. So all of these are called as tags, and then you close that also. Okay, so here I will write heading 2, and then I have heading 3. And then we have heading 4. Oops. I hope all of you are able to follow along with me. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. So heading 5, and I'll type here. Headings, again the same mistake, h6, and then heading 6. Okay, so you can see here, heading from heading 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 and 6, so all of these headings are used for a different purpose. For example, if you are writing a blog, the title or the headline of the blog, make something using Arduino, so that you write in a headline, you make it as large as possible, or the bold also. So that we usually write using heading 1, and then if you want to write your name under that, your email ID or the date of the project submitted, so you use maybe heading 3 or 4. Okay, so we have different these heading tags depending upon our use. Okay, so if I'll just click here the format this file, it will make it nice and tidy. Okay, and now so heading is done. Another thing is the paragraph. So paragraph are used using p tag. Okay, so less than bracket and then p, and if you close that, it will automatically create the closing tag for that. And in the paragraph, you can write anything. So this is a new paragraph, we are building a portfolio here. Okay, so like this, you can add paragraphs also. Okay, so in a paragraph, there is no limit. You can add as much text as you want, although there is no limit in heading also. But we use all of these tags so that we can organize our web page, because heading is a heading and a paragraph is a paragraph. Okay, so paragraph is done. And then we are going to do two more things. Heading is done, then the paragraph, and now we are going to do images and the button. So I will do the button first. Okay, but before that, I would like to show you how can we add links inside the text. So you have this paragraph and you want your users to go onto the youtube.com, onto your video, when the person is clicking onto this this text. Okay, so for that, I'll just do the a tag thing, the a tag. So onto the paragraph, the text you want to use as a link, so less than button, and the A, and here we will define the link using href equal to, and in the quotes we will add the link. So http youtube.com. okay, and then I'll close this one here, and so you can see the closing tag here. So I'll just take it out from here, and I'll put right at the end of the paragraph. Okay, so now you can see that my paragraph here, it is turned into a link. Okay, so if you just click here, it will take you to the youtube.com. so like that we can add links in different tags, like in the buttons and in the images, in the text, in the heading. So by this way you can add link to link in any your HTML element. So all of these things are called as HTML elements: the heading, the button, the paragraph. Okay, so all of these called as HTML elements. So this is done, and now we will start creating the buttons. So for the buttons, I use the button tag the same way, button, and then we define here the type of the button, because we have different types of button. We have submit button, and then we have button, the button button. Okay, so we use them for different purposes. For example, the submit button is used mainly in the forms. You may see that submit your email, your phone number, all of these things. So for that purpose you use the submit button. So I'll type here the type equal to button, and then I'll close this one. So okay, and the closing tag appears. So now I will write the text which is going to appear onto the button. So click me. So now you can see this is a button. So your text is displayed onto the button, and you can click it also, but nothing will happen because we haven't added anything here. Okay, so someone is asking question that what is the Aman Sharma is asking question that what is the difference between a compiler and an interpreter. So compiler is doing what? So compiler is used for compiled languages like C++, C, Java, Go. So all of these languages are the compiled language. So compiler is translating the language, the C++, into the machine language. So machine language is the binary, zeros and ones, and what we are writing the for loops and all of these things. So compiler is doing that stuff, and we have the interpreter also. So interpreter is used to interpret the languages which like Python or the JavaScript and the PHP. So all of these are the scripting languages. Okay, so interpreter is used for the scripting languages, and compiler is used for the compiled languages which are going to be compiled. Okay, and then here the button is done. So now I will just add an image here. So for the image, I'll use the image tag, and then so to adding an image onto a web page, what do we need at first? We need an image first. So how can we add an image here? For example, if you are building the web page onto your machine, onto your computer, in the local computer without using any website like Glitch or others, so you can just specify the path to your image. For example, C, new web page, and myname.png. So that is your image, you can add that. But here we are using Glitch, so what we can do, you can click here at the new file, and you can upload a file here. So if I just click here onto the upload a file, it will open a dialog, and here in this folder you can upload an image here. So you can upload any image, and actually in the description we have a link. From there you can have access to all of these images, because all of these images are going to be used inside this project. So I'll choose this one, the Makershala image. So we have added this image here. Okay, so if you just click onto the image, you will see the link here. Okay, so we need to copy this link so that we can add this link into our image. So copy, and you can click anywhere that this will go away. So in the index we are going to add the we are going to add our image here. So some of you are may not be able to see this, the left side, the right side where we are displaying the output. So if you click here onto the show button, onto the, we have some goggles here, show button, show, and you have two options. Next to the code, you can show your output next to the code like here, and you can show it in the new window also. Okay, so new window is here and the next to the code is here. Okay, so I will add the image to the link of the image. So for that purpose, I will use src source equal to the link of the image, which is I copied, and then I'll control V here, and I'll just close these things. And now you can see the Makershala image here. Okay, so now you will be able to see that the web page looks very ugly. Okay, we have headings and we have unformatted text. The font is not pretty good. The size of the image is not good. There is no borders. The button is very ugly, the blocky. Okay, because we haven't added any CSS here. Without the CSS, websites are just very ugly. Okay, and then okay, so now we are done. Okay, we have covered here. I'll just quickly revise all of those things, because now we are going to do basic CSS here. So here we have made the basic HTML. For that HTML, you need HTML tag, and then we have the head tags here, head section where we add titles and the body, and then we have heading from h1 to all the way to h6, and then we have paragraph to add the paragraph, and using the a tags we can add the links also, and then we have button. So you may be wondering, what are these type and src? So all of these are the attributes. Okay, so these are the attributes of a tag. We can use these attributes for different purposes. We are going to use them extensively when we will build our project. Okay, so I hope everybody is with me. Okay, and I think we can start building the, we can start adding the little bit of CSS. So I'll just quickly remove these three things here. I'll just keep the heading 1 and heading 2 because it is making my HTML very crowded. Okay, and click here, it will format the file. So now I will go on to the CSS. You will be able to see some of the things here, so I'll just remove all of them. So at first, so HTML is having a syntax here, and in similar way we have a way of writing the code here. Okay, the button is used for, you can add button for a different purposes. You just want to add button to go to next web page, or you, okay, so Awesomely Bros is asking, what is the role of a button? So you can add button for different purposes. You can add button for playing a video, you can add button for going to different web page, to opening different website. You can do a lot of things with button. It is up to you what you want to do with that. So now I forget what I wanted to do. I wanted to explain to the CSS, the basic of the CSS. So here in the HTML, we have seen, we have tags. So in CSS, what we have, how we write CSS. So first of all, we have an identifier. Okay, I will tell you what is identifier, and then we add these curly brackets. Okay, and then we have a property, and then we have the value of that property. Okay, so that is how we write the CSS. So if we again go back here, you can see that all of these things, the h1, the h2, the p, the button, okay, these are your elements. And when we use an identifier, okay, for identifying these things so that we can apply the CSS here, we can do a lot of things. Okay, so but before that, we need to link our CSS with the HTML. So how can we link that? For that we use I am writing in the head section. So link, and I will add Well, here the style sheet, and then the type, and here I will add the CSS file. Okay, so this is a way of adding a CSS file or any other file in your HTML. If you want to add a the JavaScript, we use another way for that. So now we are adding just the CSS here. So style.css, which is the name of my CSS file. Okay, if you have multiple CSS files, okay, in different web pages, you can add that also. So now the CSS has added here. Now when you want to change the look of the whole web page here, what you can do, you can change look of each block, each element, like h1 h2 p, the button, and you can also apply some rules onto the whole web page. So here, to apply applied styling to the whole web page, we use the body, and then we have the parenthesis. Okay, in the parenthesis I will write the property, and then I will write the value. So what is the property? Property is the background color, the font size, the font family, margin, padding. So all of these things come under the properties. The left side, the roundness of the corner. So all of these things are the properties. So I will write the background color, and with the colon here, I will write the change the color. So I will make it as, it is already white, actually I can make it gray. So you can type the color also, but with that we just add the basic colors. Okay, so there are multiple ways to add colors to a web page. So you can just type here the gray, then you can use the RGB code also. So we have the RGB code, and in the RGB stand for red, green and blue. Red, each of them is having values from 0 to 255. Okay, each one is having value from 0 to 255, and when we tweak the values of each other, so example, if red is more, 255, all of the other are 0, you will be able to see the red color, and with that you can make different colors. So I'll just add the red color here, 255, RGB 0 and 0. So you will see that now web page is of red color. So if you want to make it as pink, so this is the color code for pink, I remember that. And by that way you can make a web page of different colors. So how can we find the RGB code? You can just search it onto the Google. So if I'll search orange RGB code, so now you'll be able to see that we have multiple shades of the orange. So all of these are the RGB codes, and then we have this hex code also here. So we can add the hex code also. So there are multiple ways to add the background color. Okay, and so all of these hex codes and colors are available either online, or you can create your own colors also. Okay, so we have multiple tools here, like what I use. So I use this one. This is the Sketchpad, the online platform where you can do some basic graphic, you can make posters and other stuff. So here I'll just make a new web page. The new page. I'm having a habit of web pages. So you can just select the color here, and you can choose different colors. So example, this one, you can see how the color is looking, and you can change the intensity also from here, and you can see this hex code is also changing, and then you can just copy it, okay, from here, and you can add it inside your CSS. So hash is required, control V, and now it will change the color of my web page. Okay, so like that you can create different colors. You can use other tool also if you have that. So like that we can change the color of the web page. And then now I'm going to change the heading also. So heading here, so for that, if I want to change the heading, so I will use the h1 selector, and then the parenthesis will start from here, and now I will I will make this text a little bit bigger. So I will choose as font size. So font size is displayed inside the into the pixels. So I'll make it as 20 pixel. I hope it is already 20 pixels. It was larger than that, I'll make it as 40 pixels. So now you can see it is a little bit bigger. We can add the border also here. So the border, border has multiple things. You can add multiple things in the same property also. So border is 2 pixels and solid. The border could be also dotted, and then the color also, color maybe white. Okay. So here also you can do a lot of things. You can just using add the color using the color name, the white, black, and then you can add the hex codes. Then you can use the RGB colors also. Okay. So like that you can add these things, and then you we will make the corners a little bit round. So border radius, so I'll make it as 6 pixels. Okay. So now you can see that the borders are rounded now. Okay. So there are a lot of properties into the CSS. Okay. And nobody knows all of them. So we just start building things, and when we require some certain things, we can just look it up onto the Google and we can use those here. Okay, so for the checking the color, I'll use the Sketchpad 5.1. Okay, so this is my choice. You can use any website you want. I use it only for the graphic purposes or note-taking purposes only. Okay, so you can just change the color here. The Sketchpad, the sketch.io, it is a free platform. You can build some things here. So now this is the basic thing. So now I'll just quickly. So I hope everybody is clear till now. Okay. So now what we have done here, that I have changed the background color. Okay. And then I have changed the some properties of heading. But there is a problem. I have just uses the name or the tag of the heading, like H1 directly. But what if there are multiple headings in my code or in the HTML? Okay. For that purpose, we are going to have multiple headings or multiple buttons in our HTML. So for that purpose, what we do, we use a proper identifier for our tags. Okay. So we can use multiple identifier, but mainly we use two, the class and the ID. Okay. The main difference in the class and ID is that the class, we can assign a class for multiple elements. But on the ID, we need to use a unique ID for each element. Okay. So I'll just quickly add the class here in the H1. So I'll add the class equal to, I'll make it as H_1. It is up to you what you want to name it. Okay. It is purely your choice, but make sure that you will be able to recognize that what is the meaning of that. Okay. So now I have added this heading. Class in the class. And now I will use this heading, okay, so that I can just style this properly, okay. So if you want to use a class as an identifier, first for that we need to add dot here. So dot H1, okay. Now you see all of these things are same. Now we will add this identifier in the button also. So here button type equal to button. And here I will add the identifier class equal to in the quotes. It is really important. I will make it as btn1. Okay. So this is how we will add the identifier in the button. So in the style, I'll write the dot here. So dot is important when we are using identifier class as an identifier. Okay. So dot btn1 and the parentheses, the curly braces, and then here I can write a lot of things. So I will make it as background color, say I'll keep it as yellow. So now you can see that button is yellow now. So it is having a little bit of shadow or some borders here. So I'll make it as border and none. Okay, so that we can have just plain button. So I'll just quickly increase the width here, width and height of button. So width, I'll make it as say 80 pixels. And then the height also, the 40 pixels. So now the button is a little bit bigger and we can make it round and nice. So for that, border radius. Okay, so all of these are the properties, and then in the border radius we will add the value. So the border radius is going to be 8 pixels. So the 8 with the 8 pixel, the radius of the borders is going to have the value of 8 pixels. Okay, so now you can see our button is round and nice. Okay, so how cool is that? You may must be feeling very powerful now. So you just typing some buttons and writing some code here, and you are able to build all of these cool things. Okay, so isn't it cool? I hope it is very cool. So can you write cool, cool, cool here in the comments? Okay, so now we will move forward here. So I'll just quickly style the image also. So there are a couple of things which we can do in the image. So first is the identifier we need to add here. So I hope all of you are able to see. So the class equal to, and I'll write it as img1. It is my choice. You can use any the name of the class you want. Again into the CSS dot img1, and now I will change the properties of the image. So here the my image is square, but if you see onto the portfolio, the my image is round. Okay, so I want to make this image as round. So first of all, if you want to make an image as round, so you will use the border radius 50%. So now this will become round, but this only works if you have a square image. If you have a rectangular image, that will become a little bit of oval shape. Okay, and then I'll add a border here. So border, what is the width of the border? It is going to be the 4 pixels. And what is the type of border? It is going to be solid. And what is the color of border? It is going to be red. Okay, so here you can see we have added the border around an image. So now you can see that what we are doing to an ugly looking HTML, we are making it really soothing or really beautiful. Okay, so that is the use of CSS. So I'll make it as black. Okay, so I hope all of you are done till now. Okay, so now I'll wait for two or three minutes. Okay, and so a lot of people are commenting, Amanur Rahman cool, Minu Singh cool, Sandeep Chhabra cool, Rajesh Koran cool, Navya Pathak cool, very cool sir. Yes, sir is very cool. And now we have completed the basics here. So now we can just start building our portfolio. Okay, so if you have any questions, if you have any questions here, you can ask here in the comment section. I'll just wait for 5 minutes to take the questions, and then we will start building the portfolio here. Okay, so I hope everybody is done. Okay, cool, cool. Gaurav Khurana, the fabulous 5 gacha, cool, very cool name, but not as cool as mine. So the cool sir. Okay, if you have any questions, you can ask in the comments. How to add image? I have told you how to add image, but don't worry if you just missed that. We are going to add lots of images when we will build the portfolio. Okay. Okay. Shaurya Rana, very cool. And then we have Sarthak's Gaming. Okay. Okay. So Garima Narula is saying nice flow but go a little bit slow. Yes, a very rhyming, nice flow but go a little bit slow. Okay, we will move slowly from here. Okay, so we have a doubt here. What is the significance of dot here? So whenever we are using a class as an identifier, when we are using the class as an identifier, we use dot and then the name of the class. Okay, if we are just using the HTML tag like the h1 we use that only. Okay, and if we are using the class, so for that purpose we use the dot. And if we are using id, we use the hash. But in this session we are not going to use ids, we will use the classes only. Okay, then you can choose a different color code. If your hash code that you are writing is not working, you can use a different color code. Like you can just copy mine. Okay. So Nikunj Gupta, you the background, it is not the hyphen. After that, you need to add the colon here, the two dots. Okay, so you are writing the hyphen here, two colons will come. I hope the code is visible to everyone. Yes, it is visible. Okay, so I'll just again explain how to add image here. So click on to the new file. And new file, upload a file. Okay, upload a file and then choose a file. For example, if I am choosing fb.png, open it, and then the file will be uploaded here. So file is uploaded here. You just click onto the image and now you have the link here. So you can just copy this one. Okay, and then we will add that inside the index.html. So here it is the source, the link of the image. Okay, so if you want to add different image, you can make the image tag. Okay, I hope this is clear. Yes, Arjun Pratap Singh, this video is going to be available. All of the videos, the live streams are available on the Makershala YouTube channel. So you can watch them again also if you want, if you miss something. But make sure you're subscribed. Okay, so there are no doubts. I guess we can move forward and we can start building the portfolio here. Okay, so I'll just I'll remove everything and I'll start fresh. Okay, so you can just if you want, you can start a new project also, or you can just delete it and then start coding in this one only. Okay, it is up to you. So first of all, you can see here, I'll just go onto the graphic, the sketch pad. So what are the things we are going to need? So the first is, so now we are doing the web designing thing. Okay, we are just exploring the layout, what we need for building a web page, the portfolio, and where are we going to place them. So first of all, I need a profile picture and I need that to be look like a circle. Okay, and then I need some text here. So here will a little bit of my description about my personality, what I do, what I like, in just a couple of lines. Okay, my personality. Okay, in couple of lines, and then we will add some buttons here. So one button and then another button. So the first button is maybe for the skills, I'll write that later, and then another button. So first is maybe for the skills, another for the projects, and then for the awards, and then for the contact. Okay, and each button will be having different colors, so I'll just fill the colors. So first is going to maybe look like pink, second one is yellow, third is going to look like bluish, sorry, whoops, and the last one is going to look like a little greenish. Okay, so now I'll just add the text here inside them. And if you, in case you are wondering, so this is Autodesk Sketchbook Pro I am using for these whiteboard kind of thing. So first is skills, and then you have projects, and then you have awards, awards and achievement, and then we have the contact. Okay. So here my image will come, and then here a little bit of text about my personality, and here all of these buttons, and then we can also have my tagline here. So in case I am a maker, you can add your, you can add I am a future doctor, I'm an engineer, I'm a maker, I'm a budding scientist, I'm an actor, I'm a director. So all of these things. Okay, and So it is up to you. So now I guess we can start building this thing. Okay. So I'll head over to the HTML and I think now I'll move a little bit faster. Okay. So first thing, yes, there is one important thing I told that I will tell you later. So whenever we write the HTML, first thing we write is the doc type. Okay. So how we will write that? So the same less than bracket and then exclamation mark and then in the capital doc type and then in the small we have HTML and then we close it. So what is the meaning of, what is the purpose of writing this? So now we are telling our browser that we need to use the HTML5. Okay, we have previous version also HTML4, 3 and others. So for using HTML5 we need to write this tag here so that we can specify that, okay browser, we will use only the HTML5. Okay, because browsers are having support for multiple HTMLs and they may use their default version. Okay, but we need to tell the browser that I am writing my code, my HTML in HTML5 version. Okay, so when you start, so this is required. Okay, so now here I'll just show you the portfolio. So here you can see that I have skills, I have projects, the awards, the contact me and my tagline, and this is my some text about my personality and my name here also. Yes, I forgot that we need the name here also, but it is up to you. You can add name here also, like my name is Vishal and I love to break things. Okay, so first of all we need build the home page and then we will start building the others. Okay, so first of all the HTML. Okay, sorry, so this was a thing that button switching. So this is the my portfolio here. So this is the portfolio here and see, you can see all of these buttons here, and then now we will start building these things. Okay, so in the HTML first of all I need the head, and then in the head I'll need the title. So my title is going to be my portfolio. Okay, you can add yours, it is up to you. And then in the head we will need to add the styling also, the CSS link to the CSS also. And then we will move after the head, we will go on to the body here. Okay, so in the body we will start building things. So first of all I need an image. So image, the image tag. So you can just download all of these images. We have given you the link in the description. You can download the images from that link. Okay, so I think I need to move to a little bit to the left side. So I'll just move a little bit left side. Okay, so now I hope everybody is able to see me and the whiteboard and other things. Okay, so first of all I'll add an image. So for image I will use the image and then source. Okay, and then I will add the class also. Class is going to be equal to profile img. okay, and then I'll upload the image. So new file, upload a file, and I do not have my image here, but what can I do? I can use a different image here. So I'll use this one, not the phone one, I'll use the home image. You can upload your image also, and I'll just choose the home image. There is a thing that you can, if you are uploaded one image to a one project, you can use that image in multiple projects also. So, okay, so I can go to my profile here, and in the, it will load. So this is actually the code of the this one. So this is my profile and this is the code for that. And here you can see in the index I have uploaded an image. So this is an image. So I'll just copy the link of that auto. Okay, you can upload a new image also, and then you can use an early image also if you have uploaded it already. Okay, So I'll go to my project, and now in the index I'll add the link to the image. Okay, whoops. And here, okay, so now I think this will be able to display. Yes, so this was image was already rounded, so I selected the round image only. Okay, but this size is a little bit bigger. Okay, so you can add your image, you can add your Facebook profile picture and others, it is up to you, or you can just add a dummy image. So image is done, and then we need the description here. So description is going to be a paragraph, so I'll write the p tag, and for that I'll use the class. I'm already defining the identifiers here, so the class is going to be my description. So my des, it is up to you what you want to use. And then here I will define I am, my name is Vishal Sharma, I love to break things and build stuff. Okay, so this is your description about you. And then we will add a couple of buttons here. So we need 4 buttons. Okay, so I'll add the buttons here. So button type is going to be button, and then I'll add the class here. So class, I'll make it as btn1. And now this is going to be button for scales, and then I'll add some more buttons. So we can also copy and paste it, but that is not good practice if you are learning things, because when you type it again and again, it will become ingrained in your memory. So copy and pasting is not a good practice when you are a beginner. So btn2, and here I will it is going to be projects. Okay, then again button, so type is going to be button, and class is going to be btn3. Okay, this may not be the best way to do this, okay, because it is having different classes. I could have done it differently, but because we are learning things here, so this is a basic tutorial, that is why I am using this method. Projects, and then awards, then another button, so many buttons, button, the type is going to be, type is equal to button, and then the class is going to be btn4. okay, and then it will have contact me. Okay, so I'll just head over here. So now you can see that this is the image, and I have this couple of images, the couple of buttons, and this is my tagline. So you can see all of these things are spread out onto the web page, and there is no styling because we haven't added any CSS. And before we move forward, I need to add one more thing, my tagline. So that is going to be a paragraph. We can make it a heading also, no issues. So the class is going to be equal to tagline. Make sure that when you are defining a class, so you are adding double quotes here. Okay, the class, close it, I am a maker. Mine is this one. You can add your scientist, doctor, lawyer, IAS, whatever you want to be. And then I guess we are done here. Okay, so all of these things are done. Now we just need to style these things. So now we are coming on to the style part. So I'll add the CSS. I'll link the CSS with my HTML. So for that, link, and then we need to define the equal to style sheet. Type is going to be text slash CSS, and then the link to the file, so it is going to be style.css, which is this file. Okay, so make sure that this file is present here, and then the link is added. So in the style there is nothing. So Amitabh Sinha is asking, sir, can you tell me when will, okay, Awesomely Bro, does this the style include size and position? Yes, Awesomely Bros, the style includes everything, but the position, the color, the size, all of these things, we will do all of these things now. Okay, so now we will add the inside the style, we will start building. So first of all, so what we can do, as I have done earlier, we can define some things in the body which are going to be common for all of the all the web page, like the color, the background color, and then the font family, if we are adding a font. Okay, so we define these things, that these things are going to be common for all of the elements. So in the body, I'll define as background color, and I'll just keep switching on to from here to the my the actual web page, so that I can copy the color value from there. So the index style, I have this one, this color here. You can add the color of your choice. Okay, so now you can see that the color of web page has changed. And then if you need to add specific font inside your web page, okay, so we can add that using font hyphen family, and here you will add the font family. So if you just type onto the Google, you can see here, you will just type that web safe fonts, not save, it is safe. Okay, so you can see a lot of fonts here which are available here. So all of these fonts are in supported in all of the browsers, like the Mozilla Firefox, the Chrome, Safari, and the Brave. So all of these are supported in all of them. So make sure that you need use fonts from them. You can also add any form in your HTML, font in HTML, but we are not going to into that detail here. So I'll just copy this one, Comic Sans. Okay, so now you will be able to see that the font has changed here. So now all of the font has changed. So now this is done. Now we will go on to each element, and we will change the properties of each element. Like I told you, the first is image. So dot, because we are referring to a class here. So dot profile img. I hope this one is the right tag. Sorry, the right identifier. So it is, where is the image? Okay, so this is the image, and profile hyphen img is the right tag, sorry, the right class name. And now first of all, I need to make it a little bit smaller, so I'll make it as width as say 200 pixels. It is still a little bit bigger. I'll make it as 100 pixels. Profile hyphen img. Profile hyphen img, and the tag is right. So I'll just add the border to pixels, solid and black. What is happening in the image? Why it is not getting added into it? oops, so this was the issue. Yes, so that was the issue. I have added a semicolon here. So all of these things are going to keep coming in your web development or programming career. You will just add a semicolon and you will just spend a lot of time just looking for the error, which is the error here. All of these things are going to keep happening with you all the time. We spend a lot of time debugging the code rather than we spend the time making the actual code. Okay, so I'll make it as 100 pixel. And now I will make it as border. So now this one is done. So the border is done here, and I'll increase it. It will go 3%. And now, so I'll make it a little bit bigger. So it is going to be 200 pixels. Okay, so now the border was coming in a square shape. Now I have using the property, the border radius, I'll make it as the round. Okay, so border radius 50%, it will make your border round, or if you are using a square image, it will make that round. Okay, so Kavya Gaur is asking, since is going to be out of the order soon, WP Jelly. Okay, so WP Jelly is a WordPress actually going out of order soon. Do you have any idea how do can you still get the same possibilities like designing website before buying domain hosting? Please help me, I need help. Actually, there are a couple of I don't heard any news about that WordPress is going to be out of order soon, and the glitch is the right option, but for that you need to write everything from scratch. But you can also use other platform like there's one where you can drag and drop the and create website. So it has a lot of ads on the YouTube. If you just open any YouTube video, it will show Wix. So that is called as Wix.com. But now you are learning to make web pages. Why you are worrying about that? You can build a web page in 1 or 2 days and you can just deploy it. Okay. So now this one is done. And the color is, I am going to keep it as white. So I hope I am moving slow enough, and this one is done. Now I need to style my buttons also, but before that I'll just change this one, the description. So it has the class name as my_des. Again the identifier, dot identifier, and then the property. So I want to make it as width is say 200 pixels, as same as my image. Okay, then I need to add a border around that. So border, the width of the border, so it is going to be 3 pixels, and sorry, 3 pixels solid and black. Okay, so you can see the border here. So 3 is a little bit more, I'll make it as 2. And then I'll make the border a little bit round. So border, the border radius, say 6 pixels. So now it is a bit rounded. And now we need to understand a little bit concept here also. So onto the sketch pad. So here, I'll just rub this thing quickly. Whenever we are adding an element, so it has certain things. So first of all, you can add margin, you can add padding, you can add border. So this is your, suppose this is your element. Okay, so this is your element. It could be image or it could be text or anything. So first thing, what it has around it, it is called as border. Okay, So the first thing is the border, and then after that comes the padding. I'll draw it with a different color. So little bit green, not visible. Okay, so first is the border, and after that comes the padding. So then comes the padding, and after that we have the margin. Okay, after that we have the margin here. So as you can see, the padding is inside. So I'll change the padding here because it is now I'll add the padding here because it is touching the borders here. So I'll just add the padding. So it is going to be say 5 pixels. So now you can see we have added a padding. So now my text here, it is a little bit more organized. Okay. So these two things are done, but there are one more thing is remaining, the position. We will not touch the position right now. First of all, I'll just style all of the buttons, and then I'll come on to the position. Okay. Because it is a little bit of a tricky concept. So on to the buttons now. So .btn1. And now I'll add the okay. So there is a person called as Versatile YouTuber. Color is not changing, and font also. You may have missed something. Okay, so you can see here the font is going to be added like this. Font family, Comic Sans, and this, and the color you need to add the way I have added, the background color and the code of the color. It may be the hex code or it may be the RGB code. Okay. So in the BTN one, I'll change the background color. So background color, I'll make it as I want to make it as pink. For that I know the RGB code, so it is 255 0 and 200. Okay, so the color is changed here. If you can see here skills, so it is having a little bit borders. So I'll add the border none, and then I'll change the width here. So width is going to be say 60 pixels. Okay, still a little bit less, so I'll make it as 80 pixels, and then I'll change the height is say 30 pixels. Okay. Yes, a little bit bigger button, and then border radius. I want to make the corners of my border round, so border radius as 8 pixels. Okay, so now the button looks really good as compared to the first it was. And then now I'll move on to the another buttons. You can just copy and paste all of these things. Okay, and there is one more thing. So for example, like all of the buttons are going to have same kind of properties. For example, all of the buttons are going to have same width, same height, and same border radius. Okay, so why not to add just that using a trick. So we can add same property to multiple buttons, and then we can change different property for each button. Okay, so now I'll add here different buttons. So first one is button 1. And now I'll add with a comma, press a comma, and then comma, and then dot is necessary, dot btn2. So now you'll see all of the buttons are changing with only these things. Okay. And then comma dot btn3, and then comma dot btn4. Okay. Because all of the buttons are going to have the same some basic properties like the shape and the corner. Okay, so I'll just remove the background color from here. Okay, all of these properties are going to be same for all of the buttons, and then I'll just move here again, And now I will change the individual properties of the button. So here I'll write the dot btn 1. So now we will change the color of each button. So dot btn. I hope this concept is clear for everyone. So here what we have added all of these property and values onto each button. So you can add some properties to a couple of buttons or a couple of class identifier or the elements using this one. So dot btn1, dot btn2, dot btn3 and so on. Okay. So now the button 2 is going to be have different color. So background color, it will also have RGB code, which I'll copy from mine. So button 2 is having RGB code, this one. So this is the color code of yellow. Okay, and then we will add a different button dot btn3, and here I'll add the background color again. Okay, so I'll quickly copy it from mine. So this is green, and now next one is dot btn 4. Background color, then again control C, control V, control C. Oops, this one only the, so first I have copied the wrong one now. And then all of these things are done, and now I'll change the my tagline. Okay, so dot tagline, and then height is, I'll make it a little bit bigger. Height is going to be say 300 pixels, and so I hope the tag underscores minus line. Okay, so I hope everybody is able to do all of these things. Okay. Yes, tag dot tag, and then font size. So if you want to increase the font or decrease the font, so I'll use the font size, and I'll make the font size as how many, 100 pixels. Okay, so now the font is a little bit bigger. So I am a maker. Okay, and you can align it also. I'll add the border. So there is not going to be any border here, and okay, so this is going to be it for here, and now I need to just style all of these things. I'll just need to position all of this. Okay, so I hope everybody is done till now. Okay, so now we'll just start the positioning thing here, because that is a really important, and I'm able to see that all of the buttons are a little bit smaller, so I'll make them a little bit bigger. Okay, so width is going to be say 100, sorry, the 1000 is a bit more, and 100, and the height is going to be say 40. So now the buttons are looking good. So here also and this text is also a little bit smaller. And I'll change the text, sorry, the font size. I'll make it as say 30 pixels. Let's see what happens. Width is a little bit still more, so I'll make it at 250 pixels. Okay, so now it looks pretty good. So now what we need to do, we need to position our elements. And how we can position our elements? So there are multiple ways to position our elements onto the screen. Okay, so everybody is doing with me. So now we need to position our elements. So we can position our elements in multiple ways. Okay, there are different types of positioning. So the first is called as static. So static is the by default. So all of these are positioned in a way. Okay, these buttons are here, the text is here, the image is here. So all of these are positioned by default in a static way. And then we have the fixed position. So fixed position is whenever we have a static web page. So the fixed position will fix the object or the element at a certain location, and it will not move from there. Okay, you can just increase or decrease the width and it will stay there only. And then we have the relative position. So relative position, it when your element is moving relative to the its basic position, its base position. So I'll just move here onto the drawing, and a little large eraser. So here you can see so the first one was static. So static is used by default. Okay, whenever we are doing nothing, static is was going to be by default. So then we have the fixed one. So in fixed, the element is fixed at a location. Okay, and it is a pretty basic one, and we are going to use that one. And then we have relative. So relative is how, so for example, your button is here when we created it. Okay, and now you have made the position as relative. So now you will change the position relative to the base position. So this is the base position, and now you will change the location of your element with respect to this one. So if you move it as 100 pixels to the left, so it will move with respect to this one. Okay, in the fixed, it will move with respect to the viewport with your browser onto the screen. Okay, and then we have absolute also, and there is a new one called as sticky also. So we will not go into all of these details. We'll just stick with the basic one. So here first of all we need to position our image. Okay, so first of all I'll select the position as position as fixed, and then I can define that how my object is going to move, or how much is the position is going to be from left and from the right. Okay, so I can say it as from left it is going to be 50 pixels, and from the top it is going to be say 30 pixels. Okay, so now my image is from 50 pixel from left and 30 pixel from the top. So we use a different positioning method for a different websites. Okay, so if for me it is working as 50 and 30, and when we will position the button, so the coordinates which I am giving may not work for you, so you can change the position according to you. Okay, and now I'll change the position of description, so that is also going to be position fixed. Okay, and I'll change it from top it is going to be say 250 pixels, because 200 is the image, and then we have some margin for that. Okay, so now it is here, and then from left we'll keep it as same as for the image. So it is going to be 30 pixels. So now you can see we have we are making the image. Image is here, and then we have the description here. And now I'll start moving the images. So all of the buttons, so you can define here for all of the buttons, because all of the buttons will have fixed position and all of the buttons will have a certain position from the top. So we will write these two things in for all of the buttons, and then all of the buttons will have different position from the left. Okay, because one button will be at say 100, another button will be say 200, so like that. So I'll make it as position fixed. So from top it is going to be say 50 pixels. Okay, so now you can see this button is here. I think this one is, the alignment is good. We can move it a little bit down also, so 60 pixels. And now I'll start moving the buttons in the left direction. So in the left it is going to be 300 pixels. Okay, so Nimisha Gupta is saying quite excited. Yes, I hope you are joining right now. And a lot of people I am seeing that haven't subscribed to the YouTube channel. So if you are new here, if you are coming for the first time onto our YouTube channel, you can subscribe. We are posting 2 videos in a week, 2 live streams for each technology as a lockdown sessions. Okay, so now I have positioned the left at 300 pixels. So now I'll just change the second button. So it will have the, from the left it is going to be at, so 300, and I'll make it as say 500. Let's just test it out what happens. So this is the projects, and then the third button is going to be left, and from 500 I'll just add the 200 more, so the 700 pixels. Okay, so award C is here, and so this one the original which we are building right now. Okay, which that one was the previous one. So I'll make it as left say 900 pixels. Okay, so now all of these may not work for you. So if 900 is not working for you, you can keep it as 700, which is working for you. You can add that dimension. Okay, so actually we are building the static page here, and it is not going to be dynamic, and it is not going to be interactive. Okay, because what happens, because your website may need to be opened in multiple devices like laptop, desktop, the tablet or the phones. So sometimes websites may change, websites change their style according to the device they are opening. Okay, but we are building a static one, so it is just for the laptop screens or the computer screens. Okay, once you will learn all of these things, you can make your website interactive. It is very easy, not that difficult. People do that all the time. So now you can see that our buttons are positioned here, and it is little bit towards left side, so I'll make them a little bit more spread out. So the 400, I'm giving a 200 difference. 400, then 600, then another is going to be 800, and then on the left side we'll have 1000. Okay, so done. And now one thing is remaining, it is the my tagline. So I'll change the tagline also. So tagline, I'll make it as position fixed, and then position is fixed, so I'll change it and make it as say from left I want to bring it into the center. So center is about here, so say 500 pixels. Okay, and little bit towards downwards, so from top it may be at say 400 pixels. Let's see, little bit toward downwards, I'll make it as say 200. So this is the basic one. So now depending upon your requirement, you can make your image little bit more bigger, and then you can change the button, the color of the button also, and then the size of the button also. But the basic thing is that this is how we start building the web pages. Okay, there are multiple tags also which we haven't discussed, so you will learn all of them when you will do some complex project, but for the basic one this is good. Okay, so now you can do a lot of things with that. So I hope everybody is done till now. Okay, so we are done with the basic styling here. Okay, so now before we move forward, I would like to tell you one thing. So now if you want to share your project with others, okay, now you want to show, okay, this is the portfolio which I made. So what you can do, you can click onto the share button, and from here you can share your link. So this is the project page and this is the live app. So click onto the live app, and from here you will just copy this link and you can share this with anyone. So if you just click control paste here your link. So now this will display your web page. So now you can add this link to your Instagram profile, your YouTube channel, or your Twitter account, your Facebook account, into your school, whatever you are want to share your this the portfolio. You can add this link, and all of this information will the person will look, okay, this person is having these skills and all of these things. Okay, so this is the way to share. Okay, so you don't need any hosting, it is hosted on Glitch only. Awesomely Bro is asking how to assign values to button. What values? I think you are asking that how to add some functions in the button. Okay, so now what we will do, so now we are not going to add functionality in the buttons. Okay, so what we will do, we will add links into the button. Okay, so functionality is added using JavaScript. But what we can do, we can add a link to a button so that when you press a button, it will go to a different web page. So here we have created index one. Okay, so now if you just click onto the skills, nothing is happening, projects, nothing is happening, awards, nothing is happening. But if you want to go, so here it is, if I just click onto the skills button, and it will take me to the different web page. So now you can see that it is a different web page, skills.html. This is the address here. So this is what we are going to do. Now we will create a new HTML page. Okay, so I'll just click here, new file, and I'll make it as skills.html. So this is going to be a new HTML page, and here I will add all of my skills. Okay, so add this file. So you now create a new file, skills.html, and then you will be able to add a HTML file here, a new HTML file here. So skills, a new file has been added here. So this one, the old one, the index one, and then the another one is the skill.html. okay, so here if I'll just add one simple heading here, this is a skills page. So now what will happen, I want to assign this page to my skills button, that whenever I click the skill button, it will take me to the skills web page. Okay, so I'll just come to the index HTML. So like I have told you how you can add the link to the buttons, so that is what we are going to do here. So now just look a little bit carefully, I'll just make the space for all of you. So now we are going to add a link to the button. Okay, so this is the tag for the button. Okay, so this is how we added a button. So this is the button type equal to button, then class, and then the text which is going to be displayed onto the button, and then we have the ending the closing tag. So now we need to add the link here. So for the link we use the a tags, so a, and here then you define the link where you want to point when you click the button. So href equal to, so I want to point it to the skills dot HTML. okay, and then I'll close this one here, and then this is the closing for the link a tag. So I'll remove from here, and at the end of the button I'll add this one, the closing for the a. So now the point here is that whenever we are adding the link, so we need to enclose that element inside the a tag. So this is the a starting, and then the href where the you will add the link. So here it is skills dot html, and then you close this, and here you define your another element. So in this case it is button, and then the type equal to button, and then this tag will close, and then you define what is the text going to appear onto the button, skills, and then the ending tag of button. Okay, it is going to be the smaller one. Okay, so now I hope it is clear for everyone that why we are doing this and how we are doing this. And now I'm repeating this thing because this is exciting thing. If you will just click on to the skills button, it is going to take you to the different web page. So how cool is this? I hope that all of you are must be feeling very powerful, because the coding, although it is not a programming language, it gives you power to create and build things. Okay, so now we are able to build a basic portfolio. The home page is done, and now we are going to create all of the other web pages. Okay, so I hope everybody is enjoying this stream and everybody is learning. So I'll just wait here for another 2 or 3 minutes. I'll just ask the questions here. So Kavya Gaur is asking that I don't know how to code. I make website via WordPress only. Please help me regarding that. Okay, so the WordPress is also good, but you cannot customize your WordPress as much you do it with the HTML, because with HTML you are building it from the scratch. Okay, so what you can do, you can learn, because HTML and CSS, it is very basic. Okay, so there is no logic in that. You just need to learn the basic syntax, and then you can build the stuff, and then you can build your custom theme for the WordPress. And I have seen a question that what is backend and front end. So the backend is, it is from the Nimisha Gupta. So backend, when we add the main functionality, the core functionality of the website. For example, YouTube, the core functionality is that when you search something, it will display you search results, and then when you click on a video, it will display the video. So that thing, the storage of the video, the data where is stored, the search queries, the search algorithms, all of this, the logic stuff is done in the backend. We build backend using Python, C++, Go, Java, all of these languages. And then the front end is which is visible to the user. So you are seeing that video is being played on the video player. You have like button, and when you click onto the like, something happens. Okay, so all of these things, the colors, the text, the format, all of these things are comes under the front end. Okay, and then someone asking that how can we build it using, okay. So Neha Chalana is asking how to add the new HTML. So you can just click here, new file, and you can just type the name here. So I have added skills.html. So now I'll add just the projects.html. So done, and then click on to add this file. So now you will be able to see that projects.html file is added. Okay, and then you need to write the HTML inside that file. Okay, what that file is going to look like or do. Yes, Nimisha Gupta, I can understand you have a bad handwriting. I can't understand your handwriting. Yes, I get that a lot. But the people whose mind runs more, they have a bad handwriting. So if you have a bad handwriting, then you probably are a genius. But people those are good handwriting are also smart. But because my mind runs faster than my hand, so my hand try to keep up with my mind. So that is why I have a pretty bad handwriting. But you can improve it with the practice. Okay, so Kavya Gaur is saying that how come you write and speak at the same time? Appreciate it, man. Thank you. So now I have seen a question here. Someone was asking, can you build using Sublime Text? Yes. Okay, so there are a lot of things here. So first of all, we have different text editors so that we can build our program, because Glitch has just arrived. Okay, so Glitch is just arrived. I think I have discovered it a year back, and okay, so now I have the screen is visible. Okay, so Glitch is just arrived. Okay, but we have different text editors. We have Sublime Text. So I'll just because I have added, I'll not be able to show it to you here. Sublime Text. So Sublime Text is a very good text editor. It is my preference, my choice. I always code in Sublime Text only, be it for Python, be it for the JavaScript or HTML. I use a Sublime Text. It is my choice. It is free. You can use it. And then we have the VS Code also. Okay. So VS Code is from Visual Studio Code is from the Microsoft. It is also very good, but it looks very confusing to me. Okay. There are a lot of things. I don't want to be get confused when I'm doing the stuff. So you can use VS Code, and then we have other text editor also, Notepad++ and others. Genie is also one, but Sublime Text is very good. It has a very good text coloring and it works for me, and it is free also. So like that, we have completed our first web page. So now all of you are going to make a really difficult choice. Okay, so here we have been streaming for last 2 hours, and we have planned our stream till here only at first place. But if all of you want to know how to add all of these things, okay, how to add material in the projects, how to add material in the awards, how to add in the contact, if you want me to build that also, we will do that. Okay, but if you feel like you can do that on your own, I know all of you can do that on your own. So then we can end the stream here with some Q&A. Okay, now it is up to you. You can ask in the comments. But there are so many people watching me, I do not want to quit. Okay. So not audible. I think I am audible. I'll just check here. Okay, so Awesomely Bro is saying, you said in the last class that whose earbuds holder is best will get the 3D printer, but no one has uploaded the project now. How can we give the award if no one is participating? Okay, so please elaborate. I think what is the doubt? So please clear my doubt. I'm not able to understand the doubt. Okay, so Kavya Gaur is asking, HTML takes a whole lot of time to even design a basic website, or am I wrong? Please let me know if we can actually make a UI UX boosted website by HTML as a beginner. I have some ideas. Yes, obviously it is going to take time. You are building a web page, you are making all of the elements, and then you are styling all of the those elements. Yes, it is going to take a lot of time, but as you grow more, as you improve your skills, you find multiple ways to multiple shortcuts so that you can reduce the time. But it is going to take the time it is required. Okay, yes, it is a bit lengthy process. We need to add a lot of things here. So that is why we have different category of people. Some people are front end designers or the front end engineers, and then people are back end engineers. So the people, those have speciality in the back end, and there are some people those are have speciality in the front end. But it is necessity that you need basics of both. Okay, then you can choose that, okay, I want to be a front end designer because I have very good design skills, I have very good color skills, and I have experience in UX and UI. Otherwise you can say, okay, I am good at building logics and I'm good at building mathematics and all other stuff, then I'll go in the back end one. Okay, so it is your choice, but it is important that you know the basics of both. Okay, so now, okay, so here what we will do, now all of you, there is a competition for all of you. So I'll just quickly go on to the makershala.com. So now, whatever project you are building, if you are building a portfolio, so you can upload that into the community section. You can share it with others. And if you are generous enough, you can make a short video explaining your project, or you can write a text document that why I am building this and how I am building this. Okay. So this is our community page at the makershala.com. So all of you can add your projects here. Okay, you see here all of the people at Makershala see these projects, and the people, those who are the members of Makershala, you can make an account here and you will be able to see all of the projects and learn a lot of things. Okay, so we have DIY Hub here, and here all of these projects are Makershala tests. So we at Makershala build these projects and then we test them. So what happens when you go onto the YouTube, okay, on other websites, so there are a lot of projects, but when you start making them, you do not find the material, or the dimension is wrong, or the code is not working. But we have tested all of these projects. We made sure that, okay, you can make these projects using this much material. And if you need material, you can go to shop, and this is our website, makerware.in. From here you can buy all sort of maker things. You can buy components for robotics, you can buy the PVC pipes, the IoT sensors and chassis, 3D printing material, okay, art and craft material, aero modeling material. We have different kits, so you can buy those also. And then we have the courses section. So here we have different courses. These are the online courses like shapes, sound, measurement, geopositioning from grade 1 to the 9 or 10. Okay, so we have AI course, the physical computing with Arduino course, then 2D sketching, and more courses are going to come soon. Okay, we are working on a lot of courses. All of the courses will be on the makershala.com. Okay, any reward? Okay, so if you upload your project and we like that, and we means if your project is having upvotes, the more upvotes, you will get a small gift. It may be a t-shirt of the Makershala t-shirt, or depending upon the challenge. For example, it is a challenge for the creating a portfolio, so we can gift you a hosting, okay, or a custom domain for your name, which is available, if it is available. Okay, so that is going to be the reward for that. If you upload onto the community section and your project receives more upvotes, so we are going to reward your creativity. Okay, we will give you the hosting, a t-shirt and the domain name. Okay, so Ravi Kumar is asking, which is difficult task to front-end designer or back-end designer? I will say both of them are equally challenging. Okay, front-end designers are spending a lot of time to build things, and back-end also, so both of them are challenging. I will not compare that this one is easy or this one is difficult, but I can say that for me, I think for me, I'll find it more easy to work on the back-end. Okay, for me, I because for the front-end looks, it is difficult for me to work with that, because it is very tedious process, because there are no logics. You just according to the user experience, you design things, okay? But you need to have the knowledge of both. It is a must if you want to be a web developer. It is a must, and everybody need to know all of these things, because you can do a lot of things there. Without the web, there is nothing now. Okay, so now we have a lot of people here, around 900 people. So all of you who haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, hit the subscribe button. Okay, there is a red button, hit it hard, and then you will have a bell button. So click onto the bell button so that whenever we are uploading a video, you will be able to see that, you will receive the notification, because we are doing two streams in a week. On Wednesdays we are doing at 6 p.m. and then on the Sundays we are doing at 11 a.m. in the morning, and we are covering a lot of technologies. In the first session, we have made a basic game using Scratch. Then we learned design thinking process using Tinkercad. And now we are building a basic web page using HTML and CSS. And in the future sessions, we are going to cover a lot of things. Artificial intelligence, robotics, programming in Python, programming in Arduino, JavaScript, game designing. You just comment down below what topic you want this stream to be. Okay. Okay, so Kushal Jindal asking, can you give a tutorial on backend? Yes, sure, we can give a tutorial on backend. So now we'll just wrap up the whole stream. So now what all of you need to do, you need to create all of the pages. Okay, so I'll show you the my portfolio. So this is my portfolio. So this is my home page and it has multiple pages. It has skills. So if you click onto the skills, it will take you to the skills. And here I have this skills.html. Okay. So skills.html, and it has all of the content which is for the skills. Okay. And then I have a CSS for skills-style, which will have all of the styling for the skills.html page. Okay. So now you can create the pages that you want. So now if you click this home button, it will take you to the home. So in each page, we have the home button, and on the contact me page, I have these the social media icons, and these are the clickable. So if you click here, it will take you to the Facebook profile. So you can add your Facebook profile. So I hope the basic stuff is covered, and then we have the project. So in the projects, you can add project. So you are going to use all of the things which I covered here only. Okay. So if you use that, if you use all of these things, you will be able to achieve the result which you are seeing onto your screen. How can we make a web page? Kushav Jindal is asking, like a game as you showed us. It is a little bit challenging, I will say. It will take a lot of brain power and a lot of patience also. You will need a JavaScript for that. JavaScript is must. Then you will be able to make all of these things. Okay. Okay. So I hope. So by this, we come to the end of this session. I hope you learned something. Stay tuned, keep learning, and keep innovating. So if you have any questions, I'll wait for one more minute. If you have any questions, you can ask in the comments. I'll answer that. Otherwise, we'll just about to end this stream. Okay. So versatile YouTuber is asking, is it delivering in COVID-19? Yes. Yes. We are delivering in the COVID-19. Now it is allowed for the e-commerce website to deliver products. Yes, we are delivering in the COVID-19 also. So, but stay home, stay safe. What is JavaScript? So, come out of the JavaScript. So, JavaScript is a programming language, okay, which you can use to do a lot of things. Okay, you can add animations and you can add basic functionality onto the web page. So, which is for the client one, in the browser. Okay, you can add multiple animations and you can create a drag and draw option. So if I just go to the Makershala, so all of these things are made using JavaScript only. Okay, so the one thing here is that the animations, the transition from one to another, you can add that with CSS also, but that is mainly done using JavaScript. Okay, I don't want to confuse a lot of people here by giving the more and more information, because when you are in the beginning, the less you learn is the better. And you can just learn a lot of things when you go on to your journey, when the basics are covered. Okay, how much time it will take to the delivery, delivered to your home? It depends upon your location. Okay. So I hope. So Kanika Maheshwari is asking, I'm not unable to upload my portfolio to the one I made. Where you are not able to upload? On the Makershala. So you can just sign in and then you can publish, click onto this publish button, and then you can add all of the things and it will be uploaded here. Okay. So I hope all of you had fun, all of you have learned a lot of things, and I hope that you will upload, you will create a really good web pages and upload those to the makershala.com or share onto the your social media profiles. Okay, so by this, we came to the end of this video. I hope all of you learned a lot of things. Stay tuned, keep learning, and keep innovating. So bye for now.